In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Blessed fast of Saint Mary. Hoping that we all benefit spiritually. And I'm very sure in this blessed church, very special, Saint Mary in this church is very special. I was thinking what to talk about. And then thought about what we're coming, while we're coming this week to admire and to thank and to glorify Saint Mary. And I said, what was special about Saint Mary? What was the most special thing about Saint Mary? And of course, as we all know, that the most important thing of Saint Mary, that we say she is the mother of God. That's the most important thing. Of course, she was blessed. Of course, we say she was full of glory. Of course, she said from now that all generations will glorify me. But why? What was behind all this? What was really behind all this? Because she is the mother of God, Theotokos. That's why if she was focused on God, it's my turn and your turn during her fast, and actually during all our lives, is to focus on God. I am He. Ana Hoa. Ego Emi. Ego Emi is the Greek word of I am. I am. She focused on God, and in turn, He focused on her. So, as we say in the Tasbihah, the Wednesday Theotokia, the Father looked from heaven and found no one like you. Found no one like you. He looked, He searched, and He said, I found no one like you. He sent His only begotten Son, who came and took flesh from you. تطلع الآب من السماء فلم يجد من يشبهك. من يجد من يشبهك. He did not find somebody like you. Why? Because she focused on Him. During the very first age, when she was very young child in the temple, she focused on Him. And vice versa, God focused on her. It said, the Father looked from heaven and found no one like you. She was unique. No one like Saint Mary. During her fast, and actually our lives on earth, we need to think and to meditate about I am He, I am, about God Himself. What did He say about Himself? I looked in the Bible and I said, let's just focus on the Gospel of John. Gospel of John is very well known. When our Lord Jesus Christ said many things about I am, ego emi, ana ho. I'm just gonna go through a few verses and just comment on them. We need to focus on Him. So, in John 6, it said, and Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst. Hena, ana huwa al-khubz al-nazil min as-samaa'. من يأتي إلي لا يجوع أبدا ولا يعطش أبدا. In Him and only in Him we will find satisfaction. Satisfaction, I'm satisfied. What does the world today go after? And why the world go after many things? After money, authority, and many other things, because the world is not satisfied. العالم النهاردة جايع جعان جدا وعطشان قوي. Where our Lord Jesus Christ said, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst. Do I feel sometimes I'm not satisfied? Do I sometimes look at what others have and I don't have? Do I feel hungry and thirsty? And I'm always, why I don't have such and such? I remember one time, أقول القصة دي بالعربي. شاب جالي من سنين. طبعا ده من زمان. قال لي ان هو كان بيعترف عليا وبعد كده قال لي ان اخوه مر بوقت صعب قوي. ان اخوه كان عنده ابنة واحدة والبنت دي كانت كل حياته. وصادنلي البنت ديت اتوفت. قلت له اخوك عامل ايه؟ قال لي اخويا قفل على نفسه ومش عايز يشوف حد ولا يعرف حد ولا يكلم حد، وانا عايزك تكلمه. انا قعدت افكر في ذهني هكلمه اقول له ايه؟ مفيش كلام يتقال. المهم الاخ ده كان جاي يكلمني ما جاش. فانا بصراحه يعني قدامكم شكرت ربنا. لكن مرت فتره وبعدين راح شفت حد جه وانا ببص عليه كده، قلت له انت تشبه فلان، هو انت اخوه؟ قال لي ايوه. بعد سنه تقريبا قلت له انت اللي؟ قال لي ايوه انا. قلت له متاسف على اللي حصل وربنا. قال لي مش محتاج تقول حاجه يا ابونا. قال لي انا من سنه ما كنتش اقدر اقف قدامك الوقفه ديت، لكن انا ربنا عزاني. قلت له ازاي؟ قال لي انا قفلت على نفسي، لا عايز اكلم حد ولا اتفاهم مع اي حد ولا افتح كتاب ولا افتح انجيل ولا حاجه خالص، لكن من كتر حزني ربنا ما سابنيش. فانا وانا نايم في يوم حسيت او شفت او حلمت ان انا قاعد في مكان فاضي خالص في السماء على كرسي، وقدامي كرسي تاني فاضي، وشفت من بعيد حد جاي وانا مش قادر احدد مين دوت، لكن انا شايفه من بعيد جاي يقرب مني، لحد ما ذهلت لما قرب مني. قلت له كان مين؟ قال لي كان المسيح. قلت له المسيح نفسه؟ قال لي اه. وعمل ايه؟ قال لي جه وقعد جنبي وقال لي انا مش قادر اسيب عينيا من عينيه. قال لي عينيه مختلفة جدا عن اللي احنا بنشوفه ونعرفه. قلت له وبعدين؟ قال لي ولا حاجة. راح طبطب على رجلي وقال لي وأنا مش مكفيك؟ قلت له وبعدين؟ قال لي وبعد كده مشي. قلت له إيه اللي حصل؟ قال لي خلاص، كأن مفيش حاجة كانت حصلة. وأنا مش إيه؟ وأنا إيه؟ مش مكفيك؟ Am I not enough for you؟ حتى even for the worst in worst situations God is able to satisfy me. I'm the bread of life. He who comes to me shall never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst. المسيح خبز وماء حي، اللي ياخده يحس ان هو مش محتاج حاجه تانية. In John 8 he said, I'm the light of the world. He who follows me shall never walk in darkness, but have the light of life. نور. النور. In many situations, I feel that I don't know what to do. I don't know where to go. I feel confused. I feel I don't know what's happening around me. Here he said, I'm the light of the world. I am the light. I can shed the light for you to see what others can't see. I'm here to show you, to guide you. So in the conflicts that I have today, I remember he is the light. If I feel I'm hungry, he is the light, he is the bread, and he is the, what? The water, the true water that came from heaven. He said in John 10, I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and will go in and out and have fine pasture. Lots of people today, especially in where we live, the young ones say, I'm looking for freedom. And this is the land of freedom. Where they go against God or away from God, and they feel that God is a bond. However, he said, I'm the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved. That's one. Two, will go in and out and find pasture. And you remember Psalm 23, what does it say? Do you remember Psalm 23? Anybody does? Anybody does? مزمور 23 بيقول ايه؟ ها؟ الرب راعي فلا يعوزني شيء في مراع خضر يربضني على مياه البراحة يوردني يرد نفسي يهديني إلى سبل البر. ويقول هنا إنه يخرج ويدخل ويجد مرعى. There is freedom. In God there is freedom. But however, what the devil wanted to tell us, be careful with God, he's the one who's gonna bond you. He doesn't wanna make you to have fun. No, it said, we'll go in and out and find pasture. And don't forget, even before this, I'm the door, if anyone enters by me, the entrance has to be through him and by him. We have to focus on this. And in the same chapter, he said, I'm the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. Which shepherd can shepherd us more than Jesus Christ, who cares about us, who knows about us, who feels for us, and who ra'i? ما قالش انه راعي، لكن ايه؟ قال انا هو ايه؟ الراعي. مش راعي لكن ايه؟ الراعي. ومش اي الراعي لكن ايه؟ الراعي الصالح. He is the good shepherd. When I focus about on him, I find him the true, the good, the most wonderful shepherd who shepherds me. وربنا حلاوته بتاعنا، ربنا بتاعنا بيرعى كل الناس، أو بيرعى كل إنسان ويرعى كل الإنسان. يعني إيه؟ يعني إيه يرعى كل إنسان؟ ربنا يرعى كل إنسان، وكل واحد يمكن مختلف عن التاني، لكن مش بس بيرعى كل إنسان، لكن يبص على احتياجات كل واحد ويقول أنا هرعى في دي نفسيا وروحيا وعقليا وجسديا. That's why when he was with them he did not leave them to go hungry, but he fed. We have two miracles that he fed thousands of people. Why Jesus that you fed all of this? Don't you all only care about their spirit? No, and I do care about their body also. He's the true shepherd. He's the good shepherd. In John 11, he said, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me through though he may die, he shall live. من آن هو إيه؟ القيامة وإيه؟ والحياة. من آمن بي ولو مات إيه؟ فسيحيا. Life. When I focus on him, he's the life. And he's actually the only source of life. If anyone deceives and says, I can give money, I can give position, I can give whatever, but don't forget, the only source of life is God himself. In him was life. فيه كانت إيه؟ ها؟ فاكرين يوحنا واحد يقول إيه؟ فيه كانت إيه؟ الحياة. والحياة كانت إيه؟ نور الناس. في هو. ومن غيره هو يبقى إيه؟ من غيره هو إيه؟ موت. من غير المسيح موت. كل اللي ما يعرفش المسيح هو ميت. أما اللي يعرف المسيح هو اللي حي. فيه كانت الحياة. And also in John 14 he said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And in Revelation, it said, I'm the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Blessed are we. Blessed are we. You know why? Because we believe in him. أما أنتم فإيه؟ طوبى لأعينكم لأنها إيه؟ تبصر ولأذانكم لأنها إيه؟ Many generations in the past did not see what we see today. Many prophets, but actually more than that, the angels desire to see what we can see today in flesh, and they cannot see. They want to have communion as we take it, and they can't. Blessed are we, our eyes and our senses, even we're still in flesh, but we can enjoy Christ, enjoy him so much. Bread of life and water of life, light of the world, protection, good and true shepherd, Alpha and Omega. He is the resurrection, and without him, nothing. So what I want to say about this? Even that God, as we see, he's wonderful, he's awesome. What does he want from us? What does he want from us? Simply, he says, look at me, or look to me. In the book of Isaiah 45:22, he said that, look to me and be saved. All you ends of the earth, for I am God and there is no other. التفتوا إلي وإيه؟ واخلصوا يا جميع أقاصي الأرض لأني أنا الله وليس آخر. يعني ربنا عايز يقول لنا، عايز خد بالك معايا لو سمحت شوية. ممكن تركز عليا؟ بص لي هنا. التفتوا إلي. Look to me. Look to me. بص عليا. اهتم بي. خد بالك مني. أنا مهتم بيك. وأنا عيني عليك. وأنا شايفك. وأنا معاك كل يوم. ممكن تبص عليا. ربنا بيقول كده. التفتوا إلي. We find while we're driving many road directions, the direction of the heavenly path, look to me. ركز علي. فوكس علي. ممكن. ربنا بيقول لنا كده. ركز علي. And in the New Testament, Peter, Saint Peter said this, nor there is there salvation if any other, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. وليس بأحد غيره الخلاص. لأنه ليس اسم آخر تحت السماء قد أعطي بين الناس به ينبغي أن إيه؟ نخلص. ما فيش خلاص غير منه. As you remember, in the Old Testament, God got angry about the Jewish people one time while Moses was there. And he sent serpents. And they started to kill many of them. And many of the people were dying quickly. because of the serpent were very aggressive. And Moses prayed. What did God say? Tell him. Tell him, if you want to save the people, do what? Do you remember? Huh? Make. Do you remember what happened? Huh? Make. Al-Hayya al-Nuhasayya. Make a bronze serpent and put it on a rod and put it like this way. And Moses said, so what is this going to do? Should I kill the serpents with this rod? With this serpent? No. So what should I do? He said, everyone has been bitten by a serpent, just need to look at the bronze serpent. Mm-hmm. It doesn't make any sense. Just to look at it, not touch it? No. What do I have to do? Just look at it. And Moses went and made the serpent, bronze serpent, and put it on a rod, and they did this. And everyone was bitten by the serpent. If he or she looks at this, what happens? Will be saved, will not die. It doesn't make any sense for us. But what does God meant by this? Look to me. It's the same idea. Look to me. Look to me. Focus on me. Look to me. التفتوا إلي. ركزوا معايا. That's easy. It's very easy. Okay. No, it's not easy. I wish it was. There are two problems in nowadays when it comes to look to me. Two main problems. The first problem that during our daily lives, during our busy life, during our conflicts, during our troubles and tribulations and many things that happen in life, we find God is hidden. He's not there. I can't see him. And that's what really was said in the book of Isaiah. Truly you are God who hide yourself, O God of Israel, the Savior. حقاً أنت إله محتجب يا إله إسرائيل المخلص. إله إيه؟ محتجب يعني إيه؟ مش شايفينه. Hidden God. He hides himself? Maybe. A lot of times that during our tribulations and our problems and our issues and our busy life, God is hidden. I don't see him. He's not there. And that's how people a lot of times say, where are you? What happened to you? You're not listening? You don't see me? You don't care about me? I feel there is no God. He is a hidden God sometimes. When troubles and issues lots of time come and blind my eyes and blind, mute my ears, that make me not to see him. حقاً أنت إله محتجب يا إله إسرائيل. But don't forget, even if he is hidden, but he's the, the Savior. This is the issue that we do not see it. احنا بنشوفه انه محتجب لكن نسينا انه هو ايه؟ مخلص. حقا انت اله محتجب يا اله اسرائيل المخلص. Lots of times we focus on hidden God and we do not see him as a Savior, especially during our hardship times. That's the first problem. The second problem, he's not hidden. He's God. And I believe he's God. And he is my God. But you know what the problem, second problem is? He is only God between gods. He is not the God. And that's a bigger problem. He is not the God, but he is God. During our issues and our busy life, because we deal with many, many things and we're surrounded by many things, he is God. Okay, fine. But there are other gods. There is a story in the Old Testament. I don't know if you've heard it before. And it came in the book of the second book of Kings, chapter 17. The king of Assyria, الملك بتاع أشور. Should I say this in Arabic or in English? Arabic. ملك أشور تقريبا 700 سنة قبل المسيح. ملك أشور جه وسبى السامرة. انتوا عارفين طبعا ان مملكة اسرائيل اتقسمت ها في عهد مين؟ شمال وجنوب في عهد مين؟ حد فاكر؟ ها؟ ايوه the north and the south correct؟ في عهد مين؟ بعد سليمان. In the era of the son of Solomon, his name was what? لا مش أبسلوم. أيوه برافو رهبعام. رهبعام. The son of Solomon was رهبعام. So in his era, the kingdom was splitted to north and to south. North was Samaria, مملكة السامرة. والساوث كانت مملكة يهوذا جودة. Alright. And they stayed with many kings for many years. Around 740 or something, the king of Assyria, ملك أشور بقى جه, and he exiled السامرة. Exiled means he took all the young men, the powerful men, and took them to his kingdom, and he left only the kids and the women and the old people, and also he brought many of his people بقى to come and to live in Samaria. واخدين بالكم اللي حصل؟ ها؟ فهو جاب ناس من عنده وخد الشباب الصغيرين والأقوياء عنده. فربنا راح بعت لاينز, بعت يقول سباع, عارفين السبع, بعت he sent many lions to Samaria and the lions started to kill many of the people. So the people went to the king and told them to the king of Assyria لملك أشور وقال لهم الحق الناس بتاعك بيموتوا من السباع. فقال لهم طب وبعدين؟ قالوا له الظاهر الإله بتاع البلد ديت ما حبناش. أمال عمل إيه؟ قال عشان كده بعت السباع واللاينز دول عشان يموتونا. قال لهم طب وأعمل إيه؟ الوايز مين بقى؟ قالوا له أحسن حاجة تاخد كاهن من اليهود, كهنة اليهود, وتبعته هناك عشان يعلم الناس تعبد ربنا بالطريقة اللي كانوا بيعبدوها, فالإله بتاع البلد دي إيه؟ يرفع غضبه عنهم. قال لهم تاهت والأناهة, مفيش مشكلة. راح بعت كاهن يهودي وبدأ الكاهن إيه يعلم الشعب إزاي يعبدوا ربنا بالطريقة اليهودي, لأن هم أساساً كانوا أمم من أشور. بدأوا يتعلموا وبدأوا يعبدوا إيه ربنا بالطريقة اللي ربنا عايزها. But see what the book said about them. If you can بقى اتقالت الآية العجيبة ديت. They feared the Lord yet served their own gods according to the rituals of the nations from among whom they were carried away. كانوا يتقون الرب وإيه؟ يعبدون إيه؟ آلهتهم كعادة الأمم الذين سبوهم من بينهم. يعني هم شكلهم بيعملوا إيه؟ هم بيعملوا اللي الكاهن علمه لهم، لكن هم بيعبدوا كمان مين؟ يعني الطقس بتاع اليهود، لكن عبادة بتاعت مين؟ الأمم، وبيعبدوا آلهتهم. God between gods. كانوا يتقون الرب ويعبدون إيه؟ آلهتهم. دي المشكلة الثانية. المشكلة الأولى إنه hidden God. المشكلة الثانية إنه God between إيه؟ gods. مفيش مانع. دي المشكلة. We lose focus on God with one of these two things. Either I feel that he's not there, he's not listening, he's not looking at me, he doesn't care about me, or the other thing, he's God, but there are many other gods. اللي هي بالعربي يقول ايه؟ لهم سورة التقوى لكنهم ايه؟ ينكرون قوتها. كانوا يعبدون الرب لكنهم يعبدون ايه؟ آلهتهم. The common thing during our hardships to focus on the hardships and the tribulations. This is very common. The easy thing when we have conflicts, we think with our own abilities and minds and wisdom, and at the end we may go to God or not even acknowledge Him. But in all this, God is telling me, what's the message? Look to me. التفتوا إلي. بصوا علي. ركزوا معايا. خليكم معايا. دي المسج بتاع ربنا. Look to me. بص علي. هو أنا تهت ما بين الآلهة بتاع النهاردة؟ ربنا يبقى زعلان. أنا تهت. أمال بتوع بره دول يعملوا ايه؟ الناس اللي ما تعرفنيش، انتوا اسمكم مسيحيين، يعني بتتبعوا مين؟ المسيح، مش كده؟ وبنركز على المسيح. عشان كده احنا يمكن من الديانات البسيطة جدا اللي اسمنا يتبع او متسمين على اللي احنا بنتبعه. يعني مثلا اخواتنا المسلمين ما اسمهمش محمدين ولا إبراهيميين، إخواتنا اليهود ما اسمهمش موسيين ولا إبراهيميين، إحنا اسمنا مسيحيين لأن إحنا نتبع مسيحنا. طب هل أنا مركز على مسيحي ولا في وسط بقى الزيطة والدوشة والشغل ودوت بنساه؟ يقول التفتوا إلي، ركزوا علي، خدوا بالكم مني، فكروا فيا. عشان كده الكنيسة جميلة قوي، ان مديالنا قداس ومديالنا تسبيح وكتاب الأبصمودية قد كده والخلاجي قد كده والأجبية قد كده. الناس اللي بقولهم ايه ده؟ دول هيعقدونا. مش هيعقدونا، ده كل الفكرة الكنيسة عايز تقول لو مش عارف تركز مع ده طب ركز مع ده. واحد ما بيعرفش تسبيح هيسيب عندك أجبية، ما بعرفش الأجبية، طب عندك قداس، طب ما عرفش قداس، طب عندك صلاة سرية، طب ركز معايا، اشغل بالك بي، افرح بي. Do I enjoy Christ? Do I enjoy Him? Do I enjoy Him? The problem of nowadays when you see anybody, especially in the young age, when they go to any place, or they are invited to any place, what's the first thing they say? Is it gonna be fun? Is it fun? Is it fun? Will I have fun? Is it fun? Will I enjoy the fun? That's all I care about. Do I enjoy Christ? Question, do I enjoy Christ? When I come to church, do I enjoy Him? Do I enjoy the hymns? Do I enjoy the bkhur, the incense? Do I enjoy me being in the house of God? Do I believe that I don't even deserve to be here? And it's a blessing from Him that I come to the house of God and worship? Do I have this in mind? Or I got used to it? I'm taking it for granted. God is telling me, look at me. Focus on me. The last thing that I wanted to end with, if you really, you don't know what God really wants from you. He wants the best for each one of us. If you don't believe me, you need to focus and to read and to understand and to meditate on the last prayer of Christ. And this is the Holy of Holies in the whole entire Bible. ربنا عايز لينا وقاصد لينا أفضل شيء ممكن الواحد يتخيله. نعرفها منين دي؟ نعرفها من الصلوة اللي المسيح صلاها بصوت عالي قدام تلاميذه في قدس أقداس الإنجيل اللي هو يوحنا 17. يوحنا 17 أنا بعتبره قدس أقداس الكتاب المقدس، لأن هو صلى والتلاميذ سمعينه بصوت عالي، وبعد كده بدقائق أو بساعة خلاص كان دخل في مرحلة الصليب والألم. آخر حاجة عملها، What did he ask for us in John 17? It's a very deep chapter, but I wanted to just to focus on what did he ask the Father for us, for our behalf. What does he need from us? Okay, the first four things. One, he said, now I am no longer in the world. He's talking to his Father. But these are in the world about us, these, us. And I come to you, Holy Father, keep through your name those whom you have given me, that they may be one. أيها الآب القدوس احفظهم في اسمك الذين إيه؟ احفظهم في اسمك. God knows we are surrounded by many bad things, but he said, keep them in your name. أيها الآب القدوس احفظهم في اسمك. أنتوا محفوظين في اسم ربنا. محفوظين. You are protected. هو عايز while we are in the world which is full of sin and full of bad things, but he said, keep them, keep through your name, احفظهم في اسمك. فما تخافش. العالم مش كويس لكن احنا محفوظين في اسمه. And that was Jesus' prayer before he went to the cross. What else he asked for? Second, he said, not only to keep them, but also to sanctify them. قدسهم في حقك. مش بس يسيبنا ويحفظنا، لكن عايز ايه؟ يقدسنا. لو ابونا شاف اي حد منكم النهارده بعد الوعظة، بعد العشاء، يقول لك ازيك يا قديس؟ هتعمل ايه؟ هتقول له ايه؟ ازيك يا قديسة؟ هتقولي له ايه؟ بتتريق عليا ليه يا ابونا؟ انا عملت ايه؟ مش كده؟ مش كده ولا ايه؟ انتوا قديسين، انتم مدعوون للقداسة. لما ربنا قال كونوا قديسين مش بيعزم علينا، مش عزومة، اتفضل بقى قديس. الموضوع مش كده، الموضوع ايه؟ كون قديس. ده المطلوب، تكون قديس وتكوني قديس، مش عزومة، مش عزومة مراكبية زي ما بيقول. كون قديس، قدسهم في حقك. يمكن احنا مش بنفكر في ديت، لكن our Lord Jesus asked for us to be holy, and he asked the Father, sanctify them by your truth. قدسهم في حقك. في حتة في حقك دي عايزة كلام كتير، لكن briefly، ليه في حقك؟ لأن العالم النهاردة مليان بالضلالات، ضلالات كتيرة قوي. There are lots of deceptions around us. But when Jesus prayed this prayer, he said, sanctify them by your truth. Your truth, not any other truth. Because many other things say I'm truth, but it's just deceiving. First was what? ها؟ أول واحدة كانت إيه؟ احفظهم في اسمك. الثانية قدسهم في حقك. الثالثة I do not pray for these alone but also for those that they all may be be إيه؟ one ليكون الجميع إيه؟ واحدا. That all be one. And this is the desire of God, that we all become one, believe it or not. Become one. Become one in mind. Become one in goal. Become one in spirit. Why do you, let me ask you a question. Have you ever gone to a church that holds, let's say, 5,000, 6,000, 7,000 people, and Abuna said, no, we can't have communion. We have to have 2 or 3 urbanas على المذبح. Can this happen? Can this happen? No way. Why? It's only one. Why? Because it's one God, and we all share in the same body. So we all may become what? One. We come become one. Divisions is against God's desire. Divisions. But God wants us to be one. One. So anything divides between us, divides between us, you know, it's not, but we have to be one in Him, not just one in fun, not one in scout, not one, it's not about this. He has to be the one that we unite around Him. The first thing that He asked for was what? Keep them. احفظهم في اسمك. الثانية كانت ايه؟ قدسهم في حقك. Sanctify them. The third one. That they may become ايه؟ آخر حاجة بقى. ده كله ده على الأرض. في السماء بقى يقول ايه؟ أيها الآب، أريد أن هؤلاء الذين أعطيتني يكونوا معي حيث أكون أنا لينظروا مجدي الذي أعطيتني. Father, I desire that they also whom you gave me may be with me where I am, that they may behold my glory which you have given to me. لما يقول يروا مجد يعني ايه؟ Is it a show off يعني؟ عايز نحن نشوف مجده يعني؟ No, الموضوع مش كده. مش متأسف، مش تظاهر يعني. وما ليه؟ مش اي عين هتشوف مجد ربنا. مش اي عين هتستحق تشوف مجد ربنا. Not any eye will be able, will not deserve to see His glory. He said, I want them to see my glory. Do I understand this? That I will go and see His glory? That's why that verse said, ما لم تره إيه؟ عين. وما لم تسمع به إيه؟ وما لم يخطر على قلب مين؟ ما أعده الله للذين إيه؟ يحبونه. ده اللي ربنا عايزه مننا. The message is to focus on Him. As Saint Mary focused on Christ, and He vice versa focused on her. And that's how He incarnated and took flesh from her. For me and you and everyone, the message that I always need to remind myself, especially during my busy time, especially during my hardship times, especially during confusions, especially during whatever you call it, I have to focus on Him. Because it look to me. التفتوا إلي واخلصوا يا جميع أقاصي الأرض. الرسالة بتاع النهاردة أن أنا لازم أركز على ربنا. ما بقاش في الزيت. أركز عليه. أشعية، آخر حاجة أقولها، أشعية 30:15 تقول كده بقى، بالرجوع والسكون تخلصون، بالهدوء والطمأنينة تكون قوتكم. تحفظوا الآية دي؟ إيه رأيكم؟ ها؟ والشاهد بتاعها كمان 30:30 يبقى كام؟ أنا بس مش حافظها بالإنجليزي. 30:30:15 تقول إيه؟ بالرجوع والسكون تخلصون، بالهدوء والطمأنينة تكون إيه؟ قوتكم. تاني، بالرجوع والسكون تخلصون. تاني بالرجوع والسكون تخلصون، بالهدوء والطمأنينة تكون إيه؟ ده اللي بيركز مع ربنا، إنه مركز ويراجع دايما حساباته. ربنا يدينا نعمة نركز عليه كل حياتنا وفي كل مكان نوجد فيه. لإلهنا كل مجد من الآن وإلى الأبد، آمين.